Hi guys, it's Lindsay. Welcome to my channel where I share all things about homeschool on here. Today's video is going to be fun. I want to share with you guys our 2020 favorite science resources and books. So if you're looking for anything to add to your homeschool library or if you want to go to the library and get some of these books, I would encourage you guys to do so. Right now we've been just focusing on the human body and animals lately this past few quarters in our school year, but a lot of these books we've been reading throughout the year that we really like, so I wanted to share them with you guys. Usually I do a homeschool curriculum science resource video at the beginning of the year, but I don't think I did it this year, so I thought now would be a good time because I know a lot of people are looking for resources for next year. So this, I'm sure you guys heard of, it's called the DK Smithsonian Animal Encyclopedia. Anything that DK makes is so amazing. They have so many beautiful pictures, photography of the animals, and they give you the scale of, a hand and the size of the animal, or they show you a scale of a person and what size the animals are compared to a human being. These pictures are so great. My kids have tabbed all of these pages because we've been learning about things that they've been really interested in. There's little sections at the bottom where they talk about the specific tigers that they label, number 10. Number 10 will be down here. It says, tigers are the biggest and the most dangerous. Tigers range from Asia's tropical rainforest to eastern Siberia, but fewer than 5,000 are left in the wild. So there's lots of facts on animals that they like. There's so many different animals in here. You can look in the index, and then the kids can find their favorite animals and read about them. This is another book that we got probably, I don't know where we got, a consignment store. Because you can tell it's used. But you can buy this used on Amazon or Thrift Books. I'll try to link it. It's called The Berenstain Bears Science Fair. Everything small bears and kids need to know about the world and how it works. Oh wow, this is from a library. But I always think that the Berenstain Bears does such a good job on things. It talks about energy, experiments, machinery, and everything in a story form. And it is really, really interesting. Actual facts about machines. So if your kids are into how things work, this is such a good book to get. Even if you get this from the library, I'm pretty sure the library has this, and just check it out for a little bit, see if you like it, to invest in it. I'm sure this is not that expensive, but this one has been one of those books that we have really enjoyed in our house, and they talk about all different types of science and matter, and they have some little projects at the end. So we really, really like this book a lot. I also wanted to share with you guys something that we've gotten from the library. This doesn't have a cover on it. I got it used on Amazon. It is called Outside Your Window, A First Book of Nature. We've gotten this from the library and I've been wanting it forever, but it's a really expensive book, $20-some. So I got it for $8 on Amazon used. And it talks about spring, summer, winter, autumn. And it has these beautiful illustrated poetry readings in here. But these are the winter ones. We read some of these this morning. And they're very beautiful, beautifully written and beautifully illustrated. So we read one about the horse. So if your kids are into horses, and the illustrations I feel are so pretty and it makes me want to read it more. And I needed a seasonal poetry book to add to my collection because we have the same old books for years, So I wanted to get something new. This is also another book that we use all the time throughout the year. It's called Giant Science Resource Book from Evan Moritz, grades 1 through 6. So it talks about life science, environmental science, earth science, and physical science. And I love it. Oh, and space. I love it because, you can just look at it and talk to the kids about it. Or if you just want to get something really quickly done, make a photocopy of it and do a worksheet, and you can reproduce these. Whatever topic you're talking about, it's in here. The human body's in here, so we did use some of it for our human body unit study. There's animals, mammals, and earth study. So there's so much stuff in here. You can probably use it until they're in sixth grade. I probably will have this forever. There's over 400 pages worth of all of this science, and there's lots of diagrams and picture cards and things that you can just make photocopies of, or you could just teach from this book, which I have done before in the past. Same with this book. This is a body book by Scholastic. It's grades 3 through 6. I love it. We have made models of eyes and faces. We've gone over sense and hearing. And there's all these models that you can make of these actual like body parts and organs, and it's really, really fun. So we've only probably gone through like a quarter of it, but this is like the skin, and they'll go through the layers with you, and the models are so fun to make. This is the eye that we did. And then there's lots of layers that you pull back to learn about like the blood vessels, retina, the optic nerve, and we've done a lot of these. We really enjoyed this book. Now, this is The Human Body by Professor Noggin, and these are just really great games to do. You basically have this digestive system card here at the top that you will look at when you're playing the game, that the actual person will be looking at, and you ask them if they want to do student or scholar. The students is easier, the scholar is a little harder, and then you have the answers here. They just roll the dice 1 through 3, and then you ask the question, and if they get it right, they get to keep this card. And whoever gets the most cards wins, and it is a great way to learn about the human body. But they have this for history and science and all different subjects, so if you're looking for something fun with amazing pictures, you could even use the pictures for like flashcards to learn all of the different parts of the body. This is super good, and I think it's around $12 to $14 depending upon what flashcard game you get. This is another winner in our homeschool. We look at this all the time when the kids go outside when we do little nature things. My daughter always refers to this and gets this. So you can do sketches from this if you want some inspiration. Or you can just go through it like a textbook and read it to your kids in the morning time, especially if your kids really like bugs or really like flowers and leaves. This is definitely a fun one to do for the fall and springtime. So I just wanted to flip through a little bit of this for you guys. It's so pretty. Here is one series that I absolutely love for, I think, any age, to be honest with you. I think this would be good for any elementary age kid. I know it's probably a little babyish for like a fifth grader, but I would say first through fourth grade would love it. It is Cat in the Hat, and it's the Cat in the Hat's library, the learning library. And this one we've used a lot to learn about our body. This one I got used, I think, at a thrift store. I can name 50 trees, so it goes over all the trees. So if you're studying that, we've used this in our space unit study, and we love these. They give so many facts in such a fun way, and the pictures are amazing, and it rhymes, and it's fun, and you learn a lot. And so we're actually reading some learners for my son right now, Go Dog Go, all these like phonics books. And also we're going to be reading one about a dog show today, and there's also some on horses. So there are so many options. Dr. Seuss has so many great like learning books. I think they show you some in the inside here. So all of these are the Cat in the Hat's learning library. So if you want to just screenshot this, there's like tons of stuff like bugs and all the things that you want to learn about science. These are really affordable. Last but not least, I talk about these a lot on my channel. This is the older version, and then this is the newer one, and they're both incredible. It doesn't really matter which one you get. I think this one's a little cheaper. This one might be more expensive because it's newer. I mean, they have so many great resources in here, talking about space, earth, animals, and people, and I've used this so many times in our unit studies. So whatever we're learning about, I just tab ahead of time, and it's not a lot of planning. I just tab the pages that I want to read about, especially when we did human body. I read about the ears and hearing and sensing and smelling, the eyes and everything. And then also they have lots of stuff about space when we did our space unit study. So I've been using these books ever since they came out. And then this is the new one, so it looks pretty much the same. It's just very good. It has scripture, and it has something to read about and a fact, and then it has a prayer at the end. So if you are looking for a devotional that talks about science and God, this is the way to go. This is probably one of the best devotionals I've ever seen, that are very modern, and factual, that go along with, God's word and the world around us. And so I really like them putting the two together. So I really encourage you guys to grab these if you don't already have them. These are some of the must-haves in our homeschool library. I really do love going to the library and getting books about specific things that the kids want to study. But it's really nice to have like a collection of books that your kids really enjoy and they like to look at. especially like these DK Smithsonian books. There's ocean ones, things about sharks. So if your kids are into something specific that gets them really excited, might as well get like one of these encyclopedias, because they have such like beautiful photos of animals, and then they can learn more about it, and they could do it more on like their own pace, and they can look at it and read about it and just discover new things. And then it really branches out to a lot of other things. Like, you could watch videos on it. Disney Plus has some amazing documentaries that we've looked on about recently with whales and dolphins. They have stuff about lions and elephants. And so to pair it up with this and to discuss it with your kids and do a little reading assignment on their own, or a writing assignment, it's just a really nice way to do a very simple unit study. So I hope this helps you guys in picking books for your science curriculum maybe next year, or maybe just getting some for your homeschool library in the future. Let me know if you guys have any really good science books that you would recommend to others, and write it in the comments down below. I would love to hear from you guys. If you guys are not subscribed to my channel, I would love to have you guys join me here at Mama Schmoo's Homeschool Reviews. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.